how to read the data from the Excel sheet, right? So we have also one concept to read, you know, fetch the data, multiple data, like I have a one. So this type of the question they can ask in the interview. So this is your Excel sheet. We have an Excel file and they can ask, we have this Excel file is there. So here we have a username and password. This is your username and this is your password. So we have a first test cases, okay? So username here, anything like ABC 123, okay? This is the correct username and password. This is correct and this is correct. Second scenario, this is BAC. This is incorrect and this is correct. Okay, we have a CAB 312. Okay, both are incorrect. Okay, so we have a ABC and we have a 312. This is incorrect and this is correct. Write the code of this. What is your approach? This is your Excel sheet and you are going to I think I did not tell you Guru 99 one website is there. I'll show you end of the class. They're having the two project. One is your banking project, one is your e-commerce project. Just this type of the test cases are there, so you can do the practice from there. Okay, so how to, you know, write the code and how to fetch the data from this type of scenario if you have. So we can fetch the data by using the Excel sheet, right? Last session we had already discussed, but we have a one more method that is called data provider. So data provider is a annotation which is having inside this test ng. We'll go in the test ng documentation. So inside this documentation we have okay, there we are. So you go inside this documentation. So how to explore your knowledge, go in the documentation and read from there. Okay, so we have a data provider. So marks as a method and supplying the data to the test method. The annotated method must return, and what is the return type? This is the return type, object type 2D array. What is the object? Object class. This is the object class. What is object class?
Object class is the parent class of all classes and it can take all kinds of data.
Yes, so object class is available in java.lang package. You go in this Java API. So we have a inside this lang package one class is there that is called object class. So this is not from inside this Selenium, this is inside this Java one. So object class is supermost class in code Java which is available inside this java.lang package. So object class having the different method. We have a equals method inside this, we have a to string method, or else what else, get method and name method are there which is useful, right? Equals method and to a string method, hash code method. This all the methods are useful. Okay, all the methods are already there when you are creating any class. All the methods are already there when you are creating any class, because object class is inherit for every classes. Okay, So object class, if you I think go through this one, okay. Because how the data we are going to store might be this object class example is there in my system. Okay, this is, you know, object class. This is the object class of an array. Okay, so what is the, you know, someone will ask, what is the object class? Object class is a supermost class in the code Java, which is available in the java.lang package. So we will go inside this. We are using the array concept, right? So array concept is homogeneous or heterogeneous? Array is homogeneous or heterogeneous?
Homogeneous.
Anyone can others tell what is what the behavior of an array?
Both.
Yes. Array. When you are creating a array concept like types, I have created the int type of an array. You cannot store another type of the value. We can store only int type. So this is called homogeneous nature. So if you will go in the interview, they will ask the array is homogeneous or heterogeneous. Your answer is that if you are not using object type of an array, then it will behave like the homogeneous. If you want to store different type of the types of an array, then it will become what? Heterogeneous object type. We will use object type of an array. Then you can see I'm able to store int type, this double type, char type, and string type. So why this is the return type is object? Because of we can store any type value here. If you know, username and password might be a string, might be integer, right? So that's why, you know, this is, you know, this is the annotated method must be return type is 2D type of an array where each object can be assigned to a parameter list of test method, and @ test method wants to receive the data from the data provider need to use a data provider name equal to name of the annotation. I will show you what they want to tell you. I will show you in this code. Okay, so this value we have to, you know, fetch in the script. So how to do this? So I will come on this. This is my one test cases. Okay, inside this just I pass here data provider equal to test data. So I will come on this. Okay, this point they have mentioned in this documentation. This data provider needs to use data provider name equal to the name of this annotation. You can see this name, data provider name equal to, we have a name here inside this data provider. So both name must be same. Okay, so just what I did here, just we have written simple login Facebook page, that's it. We are not doing anything here. Okay, so this is our one test cases, and we have a, when you are creating any class, sorry, any, if you want to execute multiple test cases using the test ng, the one test case means one @ test annotation, and inside this we have a one method. So one method is your one test case, and by using what? @ test annotation. In code Java, execution is going to start from main method. In test ng, execution is going to start from @ test. Okay, so that's why we are not using code Java concept, right? Because we cannot achieve the multiple features of the test ng. Test ng having different features, right? So we already discussed this test ng stuff. Okay, the people who missed the classes, I will give you the backup. Some of the new class people are there, so I will give you the backup also, okay? And coming session, I will also discuss framework. So you have a one big class, one big gap, okay? Might be next weekend I will explain the framework. So if you don't have a basics, you are not able to understand the framework. So do the revision for all the things whatever I taught you. So it will like, what is going to happen in the framework? You will feel like that. Base of Selenium is Core Java. After Core Java, basics. All the, how the test engine is going to work. This, how to read the data from the Excel. Base object model, I did not discuss. Today I will discuss. So these are the three and four major component of the framework. Apart from this, we can manage all the things, okay? Not a big deal. Okay, so this time I'm going to execute one test cases by using this data provider, okay? So here I was started, so I took two parameter here, username and password. Here what I have to do, just I have to change this. This is old one. Where I kept this. I don't know it will work or not. Let's see. I think some. If you will not do the practice, you will not get the confidence. Simply, if you don't have a confidence, you will be stuck in the interview. Okay. So here I am setting this path. Okay. Launching the browser. No. Same steps I am going to repeat here. So set system.set property. Just I want to know this. You know, anyone can explain this line of the code?
Yes. I think system is a class. Set property is a method. By with method we are putting the name of the web driver and the path of the web driver. Mm-hmm. And then we just made driver is equal to new promo driver. I think we made web driver in the class level variable. That's why we can write down here, mm-hmm. like web driver promo driver, and it is method overriding.
Okay. Anyone others can explain?
Passing is it?
No, you have to explain this line of the code and this line of the code.
Explain the other one.
Okay, no problem. Who is C? Name, your name?
Sir Akshita.
Okay. Anyone others can explain?
Yeah, system.set property, here we setting the property by using system class. So inside set property method, there is a key and value. Mm. So key is specific which driver we want to launch. So like here we using Chrome driver, so using key like webdriver.chrome.driver, it is key. And value is like we have to download from the Selenium ORG. OpenTIC.org.com from the Chrome driver exe file, and we kept it in our local machine. So where we have kept it, so we have to
give the path of this,
and mm-hmm. before that web driver, we have defining a variable of web driver. So and by using this driver reference variable, we are creating new Chrome driver. So we are doing casting here as well as runtime polymorphism. That's it.
Okay, so this line of the code. Okay. So one line of the code means tell everything what you have a knowledge in the Core Java, okay? they will ask only this web driver driver equal to new Chrome driver. It might be Firefox. Okay, this is, you know, first thing happening, the upcasting. Why upcasting? What is upcasting? Means super class object type. We are going to store in the subclass type referenced variable. So interface is like a water. It is like a class only. There are six type of the class: interface, class, final class, annotation, enum. One more abstract class. So if you will go in the documentation, so interface is a type of the class. So interface always a root class, right? So this is the super class type. Super class type reference variable we are going to store in the subclass type object. So this concept is called upcasting. This concept is also called polymorphism or dynamic binding. What do you meaning of the polymorphism, right? So polymorphism we can achieve by using the overriding concept, right? Overriding and method overloading. Method overriding and method overloading. So what do you meaning of the dynamic binding? So we have a new and we have a Chrome driver, we have a Firefox driver, right? We have a IE driver. I am changing my this process of teaching, okay? Not for your batch is going to almost over. I will ask every day the question because I am not able to take demo interviews. So discussion session is there. If you will not speak, then you are not a speak in front of the interviewer also. I am giving this guarantee. If you will speak, then you will learn to how to explain. So day by day what happened, it will going to explore this. Then if you will go in the interview, then you will feel that no, I am doing same thing every day, right? QA, question answer, right? So make the habit. Someone will ask the question, whatever you have a knowledge, speak means you have to present them. Working is the different thing, cracking the interview is the different thing, and what will come with your practice, that's it, okay? So this behavior is called upcasting, okay? And this behavior is called dynamic method dispatching. I will not confuse with word. And dynamic binding. Dynamic binding means we have a one subclass type reference variable and we are going to execute multiple type of subclass object. This concept is called dynamic binding. And when you are calling this method driver dot, I'm calling this method, right? This driver dot get method, driver dot find element method. So this behavior is called runtime polymorphism. Okay, runtime polymorphism means method overriding. So you can give the complete example of this. Someone will ask OOP concept. OOP concept means I already discussed this. I think the people who are new from Java, okay, so I think I did not discuss the interface, but coming session I will discuss the interface. I have given this dummy example of this, okay?
Hello?
So yes.
We are using super class reference variable and call the method. You said like subclass reference variable and call different current object type class. So
yes,
there is in super class reference variable and calling store it different current object reference class.
No, this is according to the requirement. Only implementation what I am using now only Chrome driver only.
Yeah,
parallel execution. Yes.
Dynamic dispatch
binding.
The dynamic binding. So using super class reference variable, it's driver dot get, driver dot find element. So it's a super class reference variable, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Super class only, right?
No,
when
he was explaining that time you said like subclass.
Subclass reference bolding,
yeah.
Sorry, no, super class reference, okay. sorry, I did not check. If you will go in this documentation, you'll see this in this Java doc. We have Selenium HQ. Inside this, we have a web driver. Okay, so you can see we have a web driver. Oh, sorry, this is not a web driver. This is the web driver. So web driver having this interface. And we have this subclass subclass type Chrome driver. So this is the implementation of the subclass. Okay. So this is, you know, that's why Java is important. Okay. Selenium is what we are going to learn how to apply this all the Java concept. Okay. So that is the thing. Okay, we are launching this, and just what we are going to do. Just what I'm. Sorry, I did not open this Facebook. Facebook pe to mera ye ho gaya yaar. Sorry. Now that karna padega. Okay, leave it. I will tell you later. You know how to find the expert? Thank you. Okay, so this, you know, 2D array, why the people who have implemented this return type must be, we have to give 2D type. So here I have created the object of this 2D array type. This is the object. How to create an object, right? This is the object of 2D array. Object class 2D array. When you are I already discussed the array concept, right? So how to create an object. So simply same thing, simply we are creating an object for object class 2D array. So this is the class name, which for 2D array type class. So this is the return type is what? Object class 2D array. This is your referenced variable, new keyword, and this is what? Same class name, and here we have a row and column. It will indicate row and column. So we have a two row and two column. Same thing, it is also working on this Excel sheet. It will start from zero index. Okay, row column. So here what how it is going to work? It will become, so this is going to happen. This is your 2D array. Okay. So size is 0, 1. I think I have given two sizes only, right? 0, 1. Okay, size is 2 only, right? So it will start from this, it won't be considered. Okay, so here user name and password, what I have given. So here 00, so this is Selenium. Here it value is there. I'm taking this value from just I mentioned here 00. So here it will go in this web page. The value is, I'm going to pass here username, and again I have to take for the password. So password means enter 01. Here is your username 1, password 1. Okay, so this line of the code, what I'm going to, this, you know, this is the username 1, password. Again second one I'm giving this. So here again username 2 and password pw2. Okay, so here what? 1011, right? This value. So same you can see. So now it will, if you will execute this code, so two times it will take this username and password. I have a one assignment. If you guys might be, you learn this concept, but your TL or manager will tell, I want to use here, I want to use your for loop. I don't want to give this, like, you know, value like that. Got it? My question. I want to use for loop here. And how to use this data provider using the Excel sheet? Simply, we are reading this data and providing this. Try to do, okay, data provider read from the Google, you will get this scenario, this type of the code. Try on your side, okay? Might be, if you are working in the company, you know this concept, then how to do this? Take the help of Google, okay? Try on your side, okay? This is the thing, I have discussed this basics, this data provider, why it is the 2D array, object type, why it is the object type? Because I don't know, you know, which type of the value you are fetching, right? It might be a string, it might be any type. So that's why this is the object type, the people who had implemented. Why it is the 2D array? Because we have a multiple set of the data. So how to store this? So that's why we are using, they have, whatever the people have implemented this test in the organization. So this value is like 2D. So we have to understand the things, okay? How to understand? This is only code job, right? So taking time. Next concept is called, so it's like you can add more steps here, okay? Just I have put it here, username password. I'm not clicking on login. Add here login. Click on this login button, okay, inside this script. So what is this? Hang my system. Okay, here add one more driver dot find element, then you have to find this element here. Okay, login this page. After login, what you have to do? Log out. Add one more step, driver dot find element, log out button. Okay, so you can step, you can add more steps here. First step, first do the practice for this code and add more validation. I have given only nothing, just I am fetching this value. Then you can do some validation. If you will open the Facebook, click on this, some friends and lot of the things is there, right? So just validate more, try to explore. Means steps are, you know, make, I have given one step, make it 10 step yourself. So like that you can explore and you will get more concept, more confidence. So this is your data provider. Someone will ask, what is the data provider? Then you have to tell, okay, data provider return an array of 3x3 object, then corresponding test cases involved. That's I have written here, okay, parameter and annotated, that's it. How to find number of drop down list size, okay? So this thing I already discussed. So this, these are the interview question. So we have a tag name here, select. So how many drop down list are there on the page? So by using this we can find the size of this. How to find the link? So we have a tag name is A. How to find the table, row and table? The tag name is TD and tag name is TR. So I already discussed this. Next concept is called page object model. So if you will go in the any organization, this is mainly you have to work on this, finding the element. Why we are using page object model? What is the use of this?
Reusability, maintenance is okay.
Mm-hmm.
And like easy to change or relocate or list of things.
Yes. You are speaking, but you are not speaking confidently. Are you attending the interview?
No.
Speak confidently. What you are telling, I don't know it is correct or wrong. Speak confidently. This, that thing is going to happen. As a experience, as a professional, you have a more attitude and confidence. So in company, anyone can work, right? If you have a basics, you are not working alone, and don't join the startup company, okay? Might be you will get the offer letter, but my suggestion, don't go for a startup company for the interview. Ignore this. You are the only one person to handle everything. Then you will get frustrated. So better to join second level or third, five level of MNC company. So have a one team, okay? This team you have to work. You should not implement all the things and all, right? No. You have a specific task they will assign. If you have a basics, and definitely they will give you the KT. If you will join in the five level MNC company, they will take 1 month for, you know, making your ID and customer ID and everything, client ID and all. So like that, it will take 1 month. So you have a more time to, you know, adjust. How to adjust? So this, all the things what I'm telling, do the practice, so you will not stuck in the work. So why we are using page object model? You can see we have a, you know, flip cart. You can see this flip cart never down, right? If it will down, you can see huge loss is there. So I'll tell you, in India mostly company, you can see service based company having the more booming, earning more. Company is earning more, but employees not earning more. Okay, so mostly application is developed. We are providing the service. So automation testers and DevOps guy is doing this, all the things. Okay, developer did little bit changes and all, but that is happening in, if in this type of application is there, very less thing. But mostly people are working for maintenance of this application. So you can see, I will give you this. So you are working in this Flipkart, and you joined this as an automation tester, and so they will tell you, you are the from the scratch level of, you know, they are telling, this is the application, and you have to start the automation. How to start this from scratch? Okay, from the scratch you have to give the simple demo to the client. Okay, in the client you have to show them what the things we can automate in this Flipkart or any application. Might we will get the different domain, might we will get the healthcare domain, but only web page is there, right? So what you have to do, you have to show them. I'm telling the scratch level, but mostly company having the framework, so don't worry about that. But I will explore you, I will tell you 1, 2, and 3 framework. After that, what you have to do the practice on this first, understand the all the things of the framework. Then after that, you will come, your maturity will come day by day to, you are able to implement this framework. Okay, so that thing will come also for doing the practice only. Because if you will work in the one framework, then definitely you will think this, if I will do like that, then what will happen? If I will add this, then what will happen? How it will come, this idea, when you are working the continuously? So what we can do? So might be manual testing is done in this. So you have a testing, I mean, so you have a test cases and you have to automate. Might be some of the company, what I have seen, they have given this application and they are telling, start your testing from the scratch level. So you have to write the manual test cases. After manual test cases is, you know, done everything, then they will tell you start your automation testing. Okay, so might be manual testing is already done, you have to start from the automation testing. So you have to make the POC, proof of concept, POC, right? Yeah, proof of concept. So POC is nothing but it is a documentation, and you have to tell to the client, you have to give the demo to the client, this application I have automated. Just you have a, might be framework is there or not, if not there, just you have a implemented a framework, and you have a give the demo to the client, like just you have to give this my profile, anything, any test cases, 2 and 3 test cases, 2 and 3 validation, you have to tell them. Okay, So what happened? That is the starting from this that is going to happen. Inside this framework, we have a one concept is called page object model. What is the meaning of the page object model? Okay, simply I'm telling you guys, you have to do automation of this. Then how to do? I have given the might be 10 test cases. I have given this how to automate this. So you have to start using the testng framework. That is the thing. I will also explain this why we will not write the test cases in a main method. We cannot perform the multiple test cases. We cannot execute. We don't have any reporting features. We don't have a priority. We don't have a any depends on method. Okay. We don't have a grouping execution. We don't have a parallel execution. We cannot do the batch execution. So these are the things is not available in the main method. So that's why we are using what? We will use testng. Okay. We need all the things in the testng. Okay. So what happened? I have given, like, you can see, you are the tester. You cannot work on the only big application is there. You should not work for the all the models. These are the models of the application, right? So every models like electronics, we will go in that this electronics. If we will click in this, we have another page. See, another page is there, mobile page. So here we have to do validation for all the things, right? If we will go in this MI, we have a different page. The problem is this, if you will write this all the things in what we are, you know, learning before in the basic Selenium, if you will write this code like that, the what the problem will come, let's see, I have given this, okay, if you will write this code like that in the main method and all, so what the problem will come, because you can see how it is verify this Gmail page. So if you will write everything here, the problem is will come here. I think I did not use here find element. I think you got some basics idea why we are not using this, right? So when you will go through this page, so just simply I am going to automate and write the script on this testng. But problem is that after 5 days again you will get mail, some enhancement will happen, you have to again execute your test cases. So what happened, if something they have added in the web page, then our this will fail, right? Our locators is failed. It's too much hectic work. No, if you having this type of the requirement, this type of the requirement you are getting, okay, then what happened, our test case will fail. So that's why one concept is called, that is the page object model. So in the page object model, what you can do, we can make the one pure Java class. Every class, every page having the one class. Okay, every page of this web page having the pure Java class. So what happened, what is the benefits of this page object model? Might be this is your electronics gadget, and what else, this is your, inside this electronics we have a page for mobile, we have a laptop, we have a pen drive, like this. So what happened, yeah, some enhancement is there in this mobile page. Then what we will do, we will go inside this mobile page and we will what, we can, we will whatever the, we'll go in the test steps. According to the test steps, we will change this on like that. I have, this is all this UI package is called page object model. Okay, so every company having the using the own style, own rules of the page object model, but concept is same. I will tell you three types of the page object model. You can find in the Google, you will also get the different type. So you can see how I have written here, here verify login page, not this one. Okay, UI, com.gmail.ui, Gmail registration page. Okay, login Gmail page, logout Gmail page functionality. So every pages I have created one page object model. So what is the benefits of this? You can see what I have following this coding standard, get email text box. So in the real time you have to follow this get next button. So these are the, you know, I will tell you how to develop this, just I am telling why it is required. So what happened, some requirement will come, I got this mail, some enhancement is there, login page. So in my framework I will go here, I will add, might be some, they have added some new features, then I will add this and validate this. Might be they have changed this, then simply I will go which button they have changed, they have mentioned, oh okay, next login, next button is, you know, they did some enhancement. Then we'll check this, our XPath is going to work or not. Simply I will go there and change this. So that's why, you know, page object model is required. Okay, so I will continue this session tomorrow. Okay, this page object model, mostly whatever the important thing is there in the Selenium, I have covered this.